Value at risk is a tool to measure and quantify market risk for a bank. Market risk refers to the portfolio of tradable instruments the bank holds. Think of stocks, bonds, and options. The value of the trading portfolio varies with the market. Price drops can affect the bank's equity position. For that reason, banks monitor their market portfolio using tools such as VaR. The VaR shows the worst-case scenario for the next 24 hours. The VaR is the maximum amount the bank can lose when things go wrong on the financial markets. You could say it puts a ceiling on the losses. Say, your value at risk equals 1 million, then you can check whether you have enough equity available to absorb such a loss. If so, you will not lose any sleep. If not, you need to sell off part of the trading portfolio to reduce the risk exposure. VaR is forward-looking. It is an estimation of the size of future losses. Since we cannot be certain of these future market developments, it is common to define a confidence level, for instance, 95% certainty. To wrap this up, we can state that VaR consists of three elements. The maximum amount you can lose, for instance 1 million. The time interval, for instance, 24 hours. The confidence level, for instance, 95%. The advantage of the VaR approach is that it produces one single number that expresses the bank's market risk position. The time frame is short, often just one or a couple of days, because the assumption is that the bank can always sell tradable instruments on the financial markets. This will reduce your exposure. Banks typically calculate VaRs with confidence levels of 95% and up. So far for the theory. The question is how to calculate this VaR. One approach is the historical method that looks at price drops in the past to determine the VaR. For this we need historical price data. We can find those on the internet. Yahoo Finance is a good place to look. Let's take the example of the stock, KVW, which is listed on the Amsterdam Exchange with prices in euro. We download 501 points of historical daily prices and save the data to Excel. If you would like to have the same numbers as in our video example, you should download the data from the 17th of April 2018 through the 1st of April 2020. Make sure to look at the file extension when saving, since Yahoo delivers the data in comma-separated value format. You want to save the file in Excel format. The price we need is the adjusted close. This price is adjusted and made consistent for stock splits, dividends, etc. This is what we need for our statistical analysis. Next step is to calculate the daily price change or delta. We do this using the natural log of the Excel function ln. The natural log of today's price divided by yesterday's price is the result we want. If you are not familiar with using the natural log to calculate stock price movements, you can watch our movie on this topic. We create a separate column with the daily percentile price changes. Say, our bank holds a portfolio of just one stock, 1,000 shares KVW. The last known closing price for the 31st of March 2020 is 21.70, at the time of making this video. Then the portfolio value is €21,700. Now, we would like to know the one-day VaR with a confidence level of 95%. We can do this using the historical daily price movements we prepared for KVW. These price movements show the ups and downs of our stock. We do this as follows. For our statistical analysis, it is a good idea to assign a name to the range these 1000 daily price changes. You can do this by highlighting the range of percentile price changes and typing a name in the upper left-hand corner in the Excel sheet. Type the name delta price. For the work in Excel, we do not have defined the cell ranges. It suffices to use the name delta price. For instance, equals min delta price will give us the biggest price drop. This is -16.50%. We can find the biggest upswing using equals max delta price. This is +17.01%. We could create a distribution with along the horizontal axis a scale of price movements between the minimum and the maximum. On the vertical axis, you will find the number of times a certain price change occurred. This is the frequency. We see that on most days the price change is zero, or close to zero. The surface of this graph represents a 500 observations. The observations are sorted. The smallest price change is on the left hand. The biggest price change is on the right. We said that we would like to calculate the VaR at a certainty level of 95%. This means that we need to cover 95% of all possible price changes, hence also 95% of the surface of the graph. The total area of the graph represents 100% of the 500 data points. We could split the graph into two segments, one segment of 475 cases covered by the VaR and the remaining 25 cases that are not included in the VaR. We see this in the graph. Keep in mind that this is a graph with daily price changes. The biggest price drops we find in the left-hand tail. The area in orange is the VaR area, the area in blue is the uncovered area. The cutoff between these areas is at 5% of the observations. 25 observations are in the blue tail, 450 cases are in the orange part. The question we need to answer is, what is the percentile price change at the cutoff point between the two areas? We can find the cutoff point using the Excel percentile, EXC function. A percentile is a percentage in a sorted range. The observations at hand are sorted from small to large. We do not have to sort ourselves. Excel does this for us in the percentile, EXC function. Since we are looking for the VaR with a 95% confidence level, we need the fifth percentile. Why? Because we are looking at the left-hand tail. 100% minus 95% equals 5%. Remember, VaR is a risk management tool. For that reason, we are concerned with the left tail of the distribution where the losses are located. So, we are looking for the fifth percentile. We see that this percentile corresponds with a price drop of 2.40%. Don't get confused here, both the percentiles and the price changes are given in percentages. Now, this is the worst-case scenario that we have defined with 95% certainty. The price drop is -2.40%. This means we can lose 2.40% of our €21.700 KVW portfolio. This equals an amount of €520.17. The bank needs to answer the question whether its buffers are adequate to absorb a loss of €520.17. If so, the bank is fine, if not, then it needs to sell part of its portfolio. There is an alternative way of finding the VaR cutoff without using the percentile, EXC function. You could copy the daily price changes to a separate column in your Excel sheet. Make sure to just copy the values, not the formulas. Using the sort function in Excel, you can list the daily price changes from small to large. Now, you have the 1000 price changes in a sorted order. We are looking for the fifth percentile. This equals observation number 25 in the list. The loss equals -2.40%. This is the same result as we found earlier. So much for finding the VaR with the Excel percentile, EXC function. If you're interested how to create the frequency distribution, then stay tuned. If not, you can stop the video at this point. So how do we create the frequency distribution graph? For this, we use the Excel frequency function. This function calls for two input ranges, the data and the bins. The data we have already, these are the daily price changes. The bins are the compartments that we want to create to classify the data. Above we calculated the minimum and maximum values for the daily price changes using the min and max functions. Say, we want to create these bins with a width of 1%. You need to create bins from -8 through +13%. You could assign a name to this range. The frequency function will produce the number of observations in each of the bins. You would like to have a graph with two colors, you need to create two frequency ranges. The VaR cutoff point is at -2.40%, so close to 2% negative. The you create a frequency column for the bins up to -2%, and a second data column from -2% and up. This way you combine two data series in one graph.